With atoms mapped and a bonds table in hand, let's begin solving this mechanism. As I mentioned in the last webcast, acetic acid is the most reactive starting material and serves to protonate the substrate. Because the enone and O7 are untouched, it makes the most sense to protonate the remaining basic position, the epoxide oxygen. Notice that this also sets up epoxide opening through cleavage of the C3O8 bond, fulfilling one of the requirements of our bonds table. In the next step, we'll carry through the protonation to its most logical conclusion, opening of the epoxide via a D-N step. Atom mapping tells us that the C4O8 bond remains intact, so we should break the C3O8 bond. Doing so leaves a carbocation on carbon-3, and we've broken one of the bonds we needed to break. In addition, carbon-3 is set up for additional chemistry as a carbocation. Breaking a bond directly attached to a carbocation is unlikely, but we can accomplish the required formation of the C1-C3 bond in the next step. Pause the video now and see if you can spot the correct elementary step to accomplish this. Did you see it? A 1-2-R step leads to the migration of the C1-C2 bond to C3. The resulting intermediate is shown for you here. Additional evidence that we're traveling the correct path is the resonance stabilization of this cation. A lone pair from the adjacent oxygen atom can participate in resonance. All that remains is to generate the two double bonds and break C3-C4. The fact that we need to break a single bond and form double bonds suggests that elimination is operative, and even more notably, the two sets of atoms forming double bonds are linked by the C3-C4 bond. By treating this bond as a leaving group for one elimination and an electron source for the other, we can envision combining two elementary steps into one, resulting in an E2 plus DE combination. The resulting structure is identical to the desired product, and we have regenerated H+, a requirement for a catalytic mechanism. Finally, let's review our postulated mechanism. We had justification for each step of the way. In the first step, protonation of the epoxide, and then in the second, opening via DN, are both standard epoxide chemistry. The following 1-2-R step makes sense in light of the resonance stabilization of the resulting intermediate. And finally, the elimination yields the correct product and regenerates the acidic catalyst. In practice, it's a good idea to evaluate your mechanism step by step. If you encounter a problematic step, systematically return to it and reevaluate. Atom mapping and a bonds made and broken table are two powerful tools that you can use to help solve mechanisms. As you attempt to solve the mechanisms from this lesson, a systematic approach is essential. Use the tools provided in this lesson, along with your existing chemical knowledge, to give yourself an advantage while solving mechanisms.